Today, friends, we are going to open up and upgrade my laptop. So let's get cracking. Friends, this is my overpowered laptop. It is from 2018. It is the OP-LP2. The screws are standard Phillips head, and I'm going to take them off and I'm going to store them in this magnetic tray. I'm going to just quickly drop them in order across the row and then continue with a new row. As I continue the process, I will make an arrow here that shows where I started just so I can remember when I pick this back up. There is nothing special about this process. It just is a matter of taking them all out, making sure I've got them ready to be lined back up. Now we do need to take a moment to remove this little piece of paper so we can get to this screw right here. But then it is using the same screwdriver to simply remove it. Now I'm going to grasp back here near the edge and boom, we are inside the laptop. And we've got two M2 slots. We've got a standard SSD hard drive slot. And here is your memory if you want to upgrade that as well. Currently, check it out. We've got an entire slot available. How cool is that? All right, friends. So let's start with the memory upgrade. As you can see, 16 gig DDR4 266. That is a match to the one that was in here. Of course, I took it out and checked it out. And it simply slides in. And we can snap it down. Easy peasy. Next up, WD Black 7100. 1 terabyte hard drive, and we've actually got a spot where we can just put it in. For now, I'm going to leave both of them. This makes it easier for cloning. Really appreciate that the screw is included here. I just upgraded somebody's PC not too long ago and had to buy the screws separate. While we're in here, I'm going to use my rechargeable blower as a vacuum to see if we can suck all that dust out of there.
Of course, we'll speed that up and no sense making you listen to all that annoying noise.
At this moment, I'm just going to set the cover on here. I'm not going to fasten it until we prove everything is back in working order.
And I'm going to hit the power button. Do note with this one, it does take me a couple times all the time to get it turned on. We'll speed this up just a little bit with video editing, but here it is, and now I can sign it in. Everything fired up just like it's supposed to. Let's click down here on the search bar super quick and see just how much RAM we've got now.
And bingo, 32 gig in just a few minutes. How cool is that? I'm going to double check that the drive is available as well. You can see here, I've got 237 gig of the drive filled. That is why we're swapping to a larger drive. All right, so once again, Clonezilla, plugging in. Power this up. And I want to make sure I find the boot menu. I'm not sure which one it is, so I'm just doing F9, F10, 11. Obviously, one of them hit it, so it's going to let me pick in a minute to make sure it boots via USB. Once again, I was hammering F9, F10, F11, and F12. Those are the typical keys to get to a boot menu. I'm going to use a device, and I'm going to press Enter. Yes, I want the generic flash disk, and I'm going to press Enter. I'm going to use Clonezilla's default. This version was downloaded as an ISO file on February 15th. Notice it says operating system not permitted. Just ignore it and let it roll. It'll likely go right through, and you'll be fine. It's smart enough to find the little parts that don't work, and it just keeps finding the correct way for whatever system you're working with. You do need to pick your language. I'm going to use English. Default keyboard.
once again, let it do its thing. You could go shell or command line. I want Clonezilla, the GUI. You could go from device to an image, so that way you could use it somewhere else. Or you can go device to device, which is what I want to do. I'm going to choose beginner. Once again, disk to disk, and it needs to be a clone. And I want to clone from the 256 meg to the larger Western Digital SSD that I just added, not the other one. So I'm going to hit OK on my 256. That's the source. And I want to put it on the brand new Western Digital Black 1 terabyte and press enter. Notice you can do all sorts of checks. If you have no idea, just hit the default. I'm just going to hit the default and let it roll. Once again, if you don't know what to do, just select the default. I'm going to create a partition table because I want this one to be larger, so it's going to do it proportionally. And I'm going to press enter. When it's done, I just want it to reboot and shut off. One more time, it wants me to press enter to make sure I want it to do that. It's asking me one more time, do you really want to do this? I'm going to say yes. And yes. It is good to double check everything you chose. And then you can just let it roll.
This section right here took about 7 minutes, but I am speeding it up via video editing.
And we finally made it to the copy mode. You can see that's going to take 52 minutes. I'm not going to record all that, so I'm going to hit stop on this part of the video. And I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. As you can see, we've bumped up to about 7 gig per minute, which is pretty nice. 72% done. And so far, we've been at it 27 minutes with 10 minutes left. So about 40 minutes instead of the time that was reported. So we shaved a few minutes off after it got going. There you can see it is wrapping up. All of that happened without me touching anything. Now notice everything's done, so I can hit enter to continue. And I'm going to choose reboot. And once it reboots, unplug the USB stick.
And since it's booting fine with the original, I'm going to shut it down and let's get that hard drive swapped.
All right, so with that powered off, let's unplug it and let's set that hard drive to be the one that boots.
Which, of course, is as simple as removing one and putting it where the other one was. Easy peasy.
And, of course, we're going to store this screw back where it was, just in case I ever decide to totally swap to just M2 drives. Let's quickly put the case back on here temporarily. And fire it up. We have got a larger, faster hard drive. Huge shout out to Clonezilla for making that so easy peasy. Let's do right click and properties. Bingo. 238 gig used, 689 gig free. How cool is that?
Of course, now I've flipped it over and it's time to put it back. Don't forget we put these in order to make this process just a little bit quicker.
So there you have it, friends. That's how easy it is to update the overpowered laptop. It also just shows you that if you take your time and you open up your laptop, you never know just how easy it might be to make yours bigger, faster, and stronger. Friends, as I wrap up, I do want to say thanks to my supporters on Patreon. Absolutely love how that group is growing. Don't forget, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Of course, I also want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or hit subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and let's get cracking.